it might be for you. What we're going to do today, we're going to talk about the simple interest. Simple interest, and this is the formula for simple interest, I equals PRT. Simple interest can work for you, it can work against you. So today we're going to do a small problem here to involving simple interest to teach you how to factor a down payment. All right, so let's say you own an ATV company and you want to buy a $8,000 used ATV. So the cost of the ATV is $8,000. You don't have $8,000 currently in your budget. I know I don't. So we're going to have to use a financing company to assist us in purchase of this ATV. The beauty of that is we can figure out a monthly payment and then in little bite-sized chunks pay off this ATV over a series of three years. So here's the thing you need to know. Your credit score is terribly important when making purchases involving loans. There are three credit checking agencies, Experian, Equifax, and TransUnion, which will help you track your credit scores. It's very important to keep track of all three. One of them may have a mistake on it, where the other two might show perfectly good, and it's always good to keep track of all three. So if your credit score remains high, then your interest rate will remain low. A high credit score, and how do you get a high credit score? By paying your bills on time, that's what will make your credit score go up. That allows you to get a low interest rate on your loan. So, let's do a problem involving an ATV purchase, and I'm going to get some help from our studio audience here. All right, so the cost of an ATV is $8,000. The interest rate is 3.2%. We're going to spread the life of this loan out over 3 years. Sometimes you can spread them out over, some car loans are spread out even 5-6 years now. On a used vehicle, usually about 3 years is all that they would want to spread out a car loan in this day and time. So 3 years, 3.2%, $8,000. Okay. So what is the principal? $8,000. What is the rate? 3.2%. What is the time? 3 years. So in algebra, when you have different variables and they're all next to each other, letters next to each other, that means to multiply. So we're going to plug these numbers in here. 8,000 is the principal, 3.2% is the rate, 3 years is the time. Times those three things together and you will get the simple interest. Could you all do that for me, please? On your calculators? Did you get this? 768. That's what the simple interest is. All right, now we've got all of our variables plugged in. We know the principal, we know the rate, we know the time, and by multiplying these three things together, we can get the simple interest. But you've got to pay this back, but you've also got to pay that back. If you would have had enough money laying around in your sock drawer, which I certainly don't, to pay for the four-wheeler outright, this is what it would have cost you. But because you had to finance it, the finance company or the bank or the in-house lender is going to charge you the interest as well as the principal. So now you need to add this back to that. Here we are, $8,000, the principal, add the interest to it, and now it becomes $8,768. That is what you will have paid over the life of the loan after all the smoke and all the payments have been made. $8,768 is what you will have paid over time, over the period of 3 years, the life of the loan. So how do we figure how much is it going to cost per month? Because per month, it is very affordable to purchase this four-wheeler. So here is that number that we got here when we added the principal to the interest. Here is that number. Now, how many months are in 3 years? Well, we know that that's 36 months. Okay, 36 months is what we put here and divide this into the total that we have to pay back over the life of the loan. And the payment shoots out to us at $243.55. That's correct. Now that seems pretty manageable, right? 243.55 sure beats paying $8,000 all at once. Now, four-wheel companies that rent four-wheelers, this is not a unheard-of price for a one day of rental. So think of that. By using credit, simple interest in your favor, you can now make off of that four-wheeler $243.55 is what you have to pay per month. You can make that easily in a day. Now, that's not saying there's not all kinds of overhead costs that go along with running a rental shop as well. You got electricity, you got employee costs, unemployment insurance, you got liability insurance, and it just goes on and on. But you can see how simple interest, I equals PRT, can work for you and allow you to afford things over time that you can't afford all at once. There are ways to reduce this payment if $243.55 sounds too much. There are some other ways to perhaps reduce that payment, which may help you as well. You could stretch this amount out over 5 years. You could make a down payment. And that would be, say, make $1,000, save up a little money, or trade in another four-wheeler or something like that, where the $8,000 would turn into like $7,000 or something. That's another way. Cash is king. Cash will help you make better deals when you go in and you take cash. 3.2% interest, if you shop around, you might be able to get that interest rate lower. Look around. Different banks and in-house lenders, different loan departments can and compete to get your business. So if it pays to shop around and see what the best interest rate that you can get. I hope this lesson has helped you today. Simple interest, it can work for you. This is the formula, I equals PRT. Simple interest, principal, rate, and time. Principal times the rate times the time equals the interest. I hope you have a great day.